Hi, welcome to Summary Indexing in Splunk. I'm Alex with Splunk Education. Let's look at a brief overview of how acceleration works in Splunk.
While Splunk can search massive amounts of data, the amount of time required to return results will be affected by the number of events summarized in the report. In cases where you are running a one-off search, this might not matter much, but it can quickly become impractical when you are using these searches and frequently running reports and dashboards, taxing your deployment, and possibly slowing down search result times for all users. Splunk allows you to create summaries of your event data. These are smaller segments of event data populated by background searches that only include the data needed to fulfill the search. When you run a search against one of these summaries, it should complete significantly faster since the data you are searching over is much smaller than the original raw events. Splunk has three data summary creation methods: data model acceleration, report acceleration, and summary indexing. Data model acceleration will accelerate all fields defined in a data model. Data model acceleration is the easiest and most efficient option and will typically be your first choice. Report acceleration will use automatically created summaries to speed up completion times for certain kinds of reports. Summary indexing enables search acceleration through the manual creation of summary indexes. These indexes exist separately from the other indexes in your deployment. We suggest that you only use summary indexing for reports that do not qualify for acceleration. This includes reports that use non-streaming commands before a transforming one. A summary index is created by running a search that uses special transforming commands. When the search is run, the results are written to a summary index on the search head that can be used for searching. Creating a summary index requires a user with an admin role. The commands used to populate the summary index are the SI versions of the chart, time chart, stats, top, and rare commands. To make sure that the data populating the summary index is accurate and timely, it is suggested that you use the populating search with a frequently running report. You will want to make sure that this report runs more often than any searches that you do against the summary index. Let's create one. We have crafted a search that uses a transaction command to find out the average number of pages a user views when making a purchase on our site. The results are split by the domain that referred the customer to us and the category of the product. Since the search is using a transaction command, it can take a while to return results. Because it uses a non-streaming command before the transforming command, any report created from it cannot be accelerated. Changing the search to use the SI stats command, we see some new fields returned, and the page views field is now gone. These new fields will be used in our summary index to calculate the results returned from our transforming command. This will make more sense when we run a search later in the video. We save as a report and give it a name. You will want the name to give some indication that the report is populating a summary index. Once the report is saved, we can schedule it. We want to make sure that this report is running more frequently than any searches that will run against the summary index it creates. This will keep the data fresh for our users. To enable summary indexing, we use the Searches, Reports, and Alerts page and select Edit Summary Indexing. Enabling summary indexing, we can select which index to store the data in. By default, Summary is used. We also have an option to add fields to our data. Using these fields can give you a way to restrict data in your summary index by using them in searches. As an example, we are going to create a field called report with a value of the name of the report that populates this data. When running searches, we can use these values to only search data in the summary index that were created from this report. We can now save the summary index. Once our scheduled report has run, we use the summary index in our search. Here, we are using the report field we created to only return data from that report. Piping the search terms into the stats average function, we used in our first search, we can see results. We can also create other searches and reports that use the index. We will run this search in verbose mode in order to see the underlying events. Notice that even though we are using an event count field in our search, there is no event count field in the sidebar. This is where those special fields we saw when using the SI stats command come in. The statistical values for the event count field are stored here, and Splunk knows how to use these to get the average values we are wanting returned. This can also be limiting, since we cannot modify results before the transformation is performed. When using a summary index, you will want to avoid gaps and overlaps in your data. Gaps can occur if a populating report runs too long, past the scheduled runtime, if you are using a real-time schedule for your report, or Splunk goes down. If you end up with gaps in your data, you will need to run a backfill script. I've added a link to the Splunk documentation in the video description. Overlaps can occur if you set a report time range to be longer than the frequency of the report schedule. To avoid gaps and overlaps, be careful when scheduling the populating reports to avoid creating them.
Thanks for joining us to learn about summary indexing in Splunk. To continue your journey learning about Splunk, we suggest you check out the documentation, watch additional videos on the Splunk How-To channel, or register for learning modules from Splunk Education. Thanks for watching.